Dear viewers, welcome to this video. Today we are going to discuss in this video about yet another instantaneous assessment software, QIS. QIS is an instantaneous assessment software. It allows live games for the distance learning or formative assessment or instantaneous assessment. Students see the questions and the leaderboard on their own device. It permits to use mobile, desktop and iPad, laptop, all the gadgets they can use from anywhere. They can join for this game or assessment from anywhere. Can do it with or without a conferencing tool. We can use conferencing tool along with this quiz or without conferencing tool. So let us see what are all the major features available with this. It has three major features for the questions creation. It supports many, maybe more than 150 vernacular languages. We can set questions and answers in any of the language other than English. It has two different modes, public and private mode. It supports 500 users at a time for the assessment or gamification or playing this quiz game. Music is also supported like Kahoot. Let us see pros, cons, unique features also subsequently in this presentation. Now, let me start with comparing Kahoot and quiz. Kahoot, the host computer is used to display the questions. Students, while playing with this assessment, they may need to refer questions and answer the host machine or the teacher's machine. Then player's device only show clickable buttons or color codes. So it will take the cognitive effort more or fatigue it will lead. Whereas with the quiz, the host computer is used to monitor real-time results. That means dashboards. Player device show questions and the clickable answer options. So that is the added advantage. It is almost, I can say, Kahoot is a teacher-centric tool, whereas QIS is a learner-centric tool. So Kahoot is teacher-directed, it displays the questions and answers on the teacher's device, whereas QIS is the student-directed, it displays all the information on the student device so that the cognitive fatigue will be reduced. We can create a new question. Shortly, I will be moving towards the hands-on demonstrations. Just now, I'm just now discussing about the various features and the theoretical notions and all its benefits, pros, cons, and its merits, advantages. Subsequently, we'll move on to the hands-on session. We can teleport. That meaning teleport button, what it means is, quiz has great question banks, so you can create quizzes using past questions. So you can create quizzes using past questions you have written with your own questions or questions from other teachers. So a huge time saver if you use teleport. Or we can use couple of new questions and we can import a few questions or teleport a few questions from other teachers' study set or quiz set. We can import questions from spreadsheets too. So for the importing spreadsheets, we should follow certain format. For that format, we need to download a template. I'll show you where the template is available. Now let us see vernacular languages. What are all the inclusive features? Is quiz available in other language? It supports numerous vernacular language. Recently added internationalization support to quiz platform. So what are the inclusive features? Let us see. We can add audio for the question setting, image for both question as well as for answer. Math equations, we can use it for both the question as well as answers. When creating a new question, use icons next to the question you are writing. That new icon will help us to include these or all the features. The math button loads a keyboard of math symbols or equation editor. The media button allows you to upload audio or image. Image inclusion is for both questions and answers. Equation editor is also for both questions and answers. For question, only audio is supported. There are text formatting available. It allows to underline only for the question. It allows to underline and allows to give italic effect. And we can use limited colors. There are very few colors available for the formatting options. Now let us see the modes. It has two mode, public mode and a private mode. Public mode, it will allow us to use freely. Private mode, maybe it is a licensed version. I have not explored it. Then within that public mode, when we play the question set, it will show practice and the challenge friends. Practice is for self-paced learning. Challenge friends, we need to click the share. That share will give shareable link. Through that shareable link, all your learners can join in the as an instantaneous assessment. Otherwise, every learner directed to use joinmyquiz.com. That is a second mode. Then it will ask them to enter their name. They need to enter their name, learner's name or player's name. And they enter a game code. Every study set, whenever we play, every question set, whenever we play, it will generate a unique code, that is game code, as like Kahoot. So that game code, students need to enter to join with that quiz participation. It allows 500 users. Music is also enabled. It supports music. Now let us move to pros, cons and advantages. Let us see first start with advantages. Teachers can display student progress dashboard on the projector. A teacher can see on their own gadget to see progress of each student and instantly see how many questions the class answered right or wrong. I like quiz because it load more faster than Kahoot in my Firefox browser. So it's a fast loading, lightweight or optimized product, we can say. Quiz is different because the questions and the possible answers are displayed individually on student device. This is what the highlight of quiz. Equivalent merits of the Kahoot also we can enjoy, but it allows us to work with student-centric mode. What are all the cons? When everyone is answering different questions at different time, you lose a bit of the excitement. When with a quiz, each and every student will be answering with different questions. So that teacher may feel a lack of excitement. With Kahoot, when my class answers one question altogether, it isolates that piece of content so we can all talk about it. So the same question, same focus will be there with the Kahoot. When a quiz game is over, we can review all the questions all at once. What are all the unique features? Let us see. It gives a means card based on the player's performance. The player starts giving a continuously right answer. It gives power options also. It gives the meme card for encouragement. Whenever the player starts giving wrong answers, then it gives a memes card for the encouragement. This is kind of reinforcement system. Depending upon the way we answer, if we are giving right, then it will give encouraging cards, memes cards. If we are going wrong, it will give also the encouragement. Homework mode. This homework mode, students don't have to complete a game live in a person. We can use homework mode to assign it to be completed by a deadline. But there is a possibility of copying or referring. Those are all the answers for that question. So that homework mode, if at all we are expecting students to learn certain thing, then we can administer homework mode. But if you want to assess or grade, then we may need to go for a play mode. That is a two major difference. Let us move on to the hands-on demonstration. So quiz is the name of the software. We may need to type in the Google. When we click this first URL, it will take us to the home page of quiz. This is the home page. We may need to log in. Without login itself, we can able to pick or we can able to see lot of question banks. So if you want to administer or suitable to our topic, we may need to find here our game code through also we can join, or we can search through find a quiz. Here we can search what is the topic of quiz we are expecting. Then if it is available, we can administer directly the existing quiz. Otherwise, if we want to create our own question bank or customize the existing question bank with our suitability, then we may need to log in. Press the login button. This software allows you to log in with Google accounts like gmail.com, edu.in, ac.in. So once it logged in, let us see how to create a question. So I'm going to log in with gmail.com. So it's getting loaded. Quiz. So this is one of the quiz which I have created by myself. Let us see how we can create a new quiz. If we want to pick a gallery of pick a quiz from the gallery of quizzes, then we can navigate either by search or entering the game code. Game code we don't know. When the teacher is live and generates the game code, only then we know. Otherwise, searching. Teacher need to search here. Learner, if they know, then they can enter their game code and directly they can join. Now, these are all the way the gallery we need to navigate and search. Here, create a quiz. We need to look at top right corner for create a quiz option to start our own fresh quiz set. Now, 1 minute. Now let us title demo, video demo. So I'm giving video demo is the name of the quiz, which topic it belongs to. I'm going to give computers. Then next, click next. So now it allows us to set the quizzes. So the very first when it loaded, it gives the option new question or teleport. New question is to create a question by the teacher individually. Whereas teleport is to bring the existing quiz set with this quiz set or part of that existing quiz set to the present quiz set. Let me show one by one. So we no need to press new question. Already we are in the new question, but we need to go through the available options, multiple choice. Multiple choices for only one right answer. Checkbox. It is for more than one right answer. It could be two right answers or three right answers. Fill in the blank. It's for meant for fill in the blank. Polling. Open-ended question. Open-ended question, teacher may need to evaluate. It will not do any auto-evaluation option. Whereas multiple choice and the checkbox, fill in the blanks, it does auto-evaluation. Now, we need to see. It should be in the public mode. English. It is by default, it is available in the language English. If you want to choose any other vernacular language, we can choose any other vernacular language. Similarly, quiz image. Suppose if you want to represent unit 1, data analytics, we can pick a team image if you wish. Otherwise, it doesn't recover. So now let me choose multiple choice. Now, I'm just going to copy paste the existing question which I have already. I'm going to bring that question here. Over. Instead, we can type also. If you have the question bank already either in the form of Microsoft Word or Excel or PDF format, then we can copy paste. Otherwise, then italic. For example, I want to highlight these two events be disjoint. Italic, I can give. Underline, I can give. Formatting options. Color. It permits, these are all the four colors. So I can give any one of the color if I want to distinguish. Otherwise, it is not required. Similarly, if we click this triple dot, we can able to see the equation editors, that superscript, subscript option. Then if you want to give any mathematical equation, we can click this math. With that math, we can get into equation editor. Right now, it is not required. For the demonstration purpose, I'm going to show like this. Now, integration of x, I'm going to give 1. And instead of y, I'm going to do 4, then x dx, insert. Now my equation is ready. The same equation editor helps for, with the advanced mode, chemistry equations we can form with bidirectional, unidirectional, forward reaction, backward reaction, like that we can use. There are three options available, basic option, Greek letters and advanced options. So these are all the limited options available. We can use any one of these. Otherwise, as I mentioned in the previous videos, CodeCox, that is one of the websites. Just I type and I will delete. CodeCox is the website. There you can type the equation. It has rich mathematical equation features. Then we can save that equation as an image. Then we can use the next option, this media option, to incorporate that equation along with the questions. There are two ways. If it doesn't provide the necessary features for setting the equation, then we can use CodeCox for equations. Then we can come back with this media. We can import that equation image. So these are all the possible answers. Let me go to the answers option. This is yes or no type question. So I'm typing yes. Then here I'm typing no. Then the right answer we must enable. No, it is irrelevant. So I'm going to delete it, this option. Yeah, just a delete button is sufficient. It gets deleted. Now, first question is ready. Now, if we look at the bottom left-hand side, it is shows the timing options, timer. So if you want to set 45 seconds, 30 seconds, whichever the suitable time or complexity of the question, we can set. Since it is true or false or yes or no type question, I can set 30 seconds. However, they need to read the question and they need to think of it. So that I can give 45 seconds also, because it's mathematics, then we need to calculate it. It takes a couple of minutes. So same. Once the question is ready, here it shows the way it appears for the students. So other unnecessary options I'm deleting so that it becomes very elegant. So for that, I'm deleting all the unnecessary options. By default, it gives four answer options. Say, the first question is ready. Let me show the demonstration with the second question. So what we need to do when we move to the second question. So if you look at multiple choice, checkbox, fill in the blank, poll, and open-ended. Again, it shows here. If we want, we can use anything. Otherwise, I'm clicking new question. So again, multiple choice. Any one method we can move. Let me show one image, setting one image. I'm importing image from the desktop. So I'm setting the question. Image, import, context, open. Yeah, it's loading. It takes a lot of time for loading. Now, with that, which is the software shown in the displayed image? I'm just setting the question. I'm giving here visual effect, the software for visual effect, logo design, graphics, and text generator. Even for answer, we can set the equation as well as image. The same procedure, what I'm doing for question, same procedure. Now, graphical text generator, all the above. This is a tool or software, we can use it for all the above. So I'm setting the right answer. Then similarly, we can choose 45 second or 60 second depending upon the complexity of the question. Then say, now over. Either we can click this or we can click here. So whichever we want. Now with the image, with the text, with the equation editor, we have discussed all the three combinations. Now I will show you the option how to teleport the existing question. Now teleport. Click this option, teleport. Then I can give the option. Video demo is the option it is taking by default. I need to delete this or else I can search. So instead of video demo, data analytics, teleport, public quizzes, data analytics. I'm going to bring data analytics question with this video demo question bank which I am creating. So there are 21 questions available. I can read each and every question with the answer it is available. So now summarize and analyze data with both cross tabulation and charting, pivot chart. If I like, say if you, after teleporting, it shows add this question I want to include. Immediately it starts including into my question bank. Video demo have got this question in addition to the existing two questions which I have created. Now, chart for displaying multiple variables, scatter chart, I want to include, add. Now I'm going to scroll down. There are other questions I don't want. I want to pick a question which I want to do. Now, examining data with more than two variables, parallel coordinates plot, I like it. So I'm bringing here. So I can scroll. Rather, I can go to second data analytics question also. Here, whichever data analytics helps you analyze the data you have. Yes, add, I want it. Similarly, we can do n number of big data. Which expression is no valid Python code? Result, this combination of doing concatenation is not possible, or mixed data type is not possible. So something like that. Now, enough. So what I need to do, let me click here. That's it. So there are three total. I have set 5 questions here. It shows the number of questions. The first 2 questions I have created. The other questions I have teleported. Total 7 questions. So 7 questions I have teleported. Now for whichever the question I have teleported, I need to customize suitable to my learner. So 30 seconds I am increasing. For the other question, I am going to give 30 seconds. This is also 10 seconds. It would not be sufficient a time. So 20 seconds. Students may be pressurized. So next 30 seconds, it's optimum. Last also 30 seconds, it's optimum. So this all the way we can teleport. See, here the option, new question for creating new question repeatedly, what we are excited to create. Otherwise, teleport. Teleport, we need to click and delete video demo. By default, it will have that video demo. We need to delete what we want. For example, web technology. What we are interested, that topic we need to type and search. There is no, web technology, food technology is all web technology, 11 questions, web technology, whichever we want, we need to click. Let us go through only, it has only 2 questions. So if you wish, you can collect any one of the question, or if not, you can change the study set, go through it, then we can add. That's it, click that. So it allows question wise adding, entire question bank we can't teleport. After clicking a question bank, we may need to look at each and every question, which question we are interested to teleport to our study set or question set, that is possible. Now, these are all the options we have discussed. Now, another option, notable option, I haven't explored, but I'm just bringing a note, import from spreadsheet. For that, this template we need to download. This template guides us where we need to keep the question, where we need to keep the answer 1, answer 2, answer 3, answer 4, etc. or answer n. Then how to, where we need to keep the right answer, something like that. So it's a formatted sheet. So we need to adhere to that format. Then we need to drag and drop, or we can upload the file for creating a new question bank. So this is the option. Now, once the study set is ready, yes, for me it's sufficient. 7 questions I have created with the data analytics. Although the title kept it as video demo, I have created the questions of the category data analytics. Now, one is of different. This question, which is the software shown displayed in this? So question number 2 is related to software, different software. Now done. Everything is over. If you want to customize or decorate your question with the image, so add quiz image. Simple, that's all. So it gives a decoration. For example, this is about comparison of Kahoot and quiz. So I'm giving that image. Then this would become header image of the quiz set. So that the quiz set will have this image. It asks to select the grade. So professional development or university level, public visible everyone, that's it. So these are all few customizing procedures we need to do, that's all. Now, this is what video demo has, its own header picture, that's it, nothing more. So if you want, we can do, otherwise we can delete, or it is not recovered. So now done, click done. Everything is over means we need to click done. Then, once you log in, all your gallery would be available. I have created long back education technology, STC demo, data science, and this. It will start accumulating into your own gallery. So next, whenever you are comfortable, today is the day I'm creating a study set or question set. After 20 days or after 15 days, I want to administer this. Then double click this. That's it. If you double click, it will show 2 options. Practice, challenge friends. Practice is for self-paced learning. Challenge friends, we need to click when teacher want to assess students instantaneously. Then let me click practice. From here also we can go practice. See, practice starts with a play quiz. Individually, I can play and I can know my score, or else flashcard. This flashcard is for reading mode. Being a learner, first I can learn based on the question and answer set by the teacher, then I can play quiz. Challenge friends is for always, even teacher also, it says friend, challenge friend. So it used the word cordial word challenge friends. So we'll be challenging our students for that challenge friends. Three mode. Let me show flashcard mode. First, whenever we are using self-paced or practice, no, first students must learn. So this is the starting point. The starting point, it shows what is the header image and what is the title of the quiz set. Then start. Click start. So it shows me the question. I'm reading the question. I'm understanding the question being a learner when I am into self-paced study mode. Flip. It shows the answer no. I need to click got it. I understood. Then it takes me to the next. Which expression is no valid Python code? Flip. Then it gives. This kind of learning exercise, but it is not a grading or assessment exercise. So whenever we are expecting students to learn something, then we can put them in this mode. Otherwise, challenge mode, challenge friends. That is the mode. Got it. So likewise, I can read all the questions. I'm just clicking fast. We have 7 questions. This is a flip, got it. Flip, got it. 7 out of 7. Review again. Back home. I need to go for back home. Then if I click back home, how to share that study set with your student for the self-paced learning? Let us see. Loading now. Again, that study set, I need to click home. Yeah, otherwise I can search here, video demo. Can search that study set. Now video demo. Now we came to video demo. Next, play quiz. Play quiz, it gives means card while playing, depending upon whether we are all the time we are right or all the time we are wrong, or individual questions we are wrong, or couple of questions we are right. Depending upon that, soon after the completion of that question, immediately it gives a memes card. So that would be encouraging or exciting. That is added advantage. And it gives PowerPoints continuously. If we do right answer, it gives PowerPoint. Let me use play quiz. Whatever I am doing, flashcard and the play quiz is for learner end, not a teacher end. So how to share this study set? Yes, I have created. How my students come to know that what I want to do? See, after double clicking that self-paced mode or even the challenge friends mode, we will see share. If we click, there is a link. We need to copy this. See, here link. Control A. Here this portion, Control A, Control C. I need to share this link either in the Google Classroom or WhatsApp or in the Gmail, where whichever the mode we want to communicate, we can communicate. This is the way for self-paced learning or play quiz. Now, let me use the play quiz option. Flashcard mode is over. Play quiz option. Next, it gives the music. 1, 2, 3. Since I'm using headphone, I only could hear the music. Now, it asks me events. No, I'm giving. See, I know the answer, so quickly I'm giving. See, it's don't like the music, pass the OK cable. It gives me the leaderboard. Then second question, chart for displaying multiple variables. If I give you a wrong answer, what it does? Just for demo, I'm showing. So this, it shows the leaderboard. Data analytics help to analyze the data you have. Yes, right. Then it gives the meme card. Kudo, help me study. So next, it shows me the leaderboard. Next question. Summarize, analyze data with both cross-tabulation and charting, pivot chart. Right. If I give right, it gives me the leaderboard. Which expression is no valid? I'm giving wrong answer. While giving wrong answer, how it changes the leaderboard? Examining data and more than 2 variable, what it is parallel coordinate plot. Right answer, power up. So if we are giving more right answer, we will be getting streak saver power up. So this is the power card. It's like a gamification mode. So after that power saver, this has all the above. So now onwards, let me try to give all right answers. See, for the encouraging word. It shows the leaderboard. Reattempt the question, got wrong. It gives me the choice. displaying multiple variables, scatter chart matrix. Right answer. It gives me some memes card. Game ended. Over. It gives the music with a dashboard. Now, we may need to go for challenge, friends. Now we are moving to the third option, challenge friends, but this is what the option always a teacher need to prefer for instantaneous assessment. Rest all for self-paced learning. So let us click this challenge friends. Before that, power-ups. If you want to give power-ups, you can give. Memes, if you are interested, you can give. Otherwise, you can toggle off. No, if you are not interested to administer memes during the participation, we can toggle off. Timer. If you don't want timer, otherwise it will be into pressurized mode, competitive mode. Students will not think and they will be curious to click the answer. Then choices yours. What are the modes teacher is interested to grant, they can grant. Otherwise, it's not required. Now, no, challenge friends. I'm clicking challenge friends. Then it comes to this mode. Then who is the name of the quiz or who is giving. Then it gives the code, pin game code. Now start game. The moment we give start game, as I mentioned, this is what the URL, no space, joinmyquiz.com. They need to type students. Then it will ask them to enter the code. Then they need to enter. Then the moment this code is entered, it will ask them to enter their name also. Then they need to enter. Already one member joined here. Then I need to start. When I get the start button will be enabled, minimum two players joins in this quiz only, it will enable. It is like almost a Kahoot only. Then it will have quizzes. We need to push. At the end of the participation, after 30 seconds or the time set or all the players are played, then it will show the dashboard to the teacher and we need to click the next button. That's it, nothing more. So finally it announces the winners also. It shows the dashboard individually also as like Kahoot. And finally we can take a report also for the study set. So far now I haven't administered this quiz for students, larger number of audiences. So I'm not having the report right now. So once if you do it, then the report will be available. Then with that report, it could be evidence or it could be a portfolio for the showcase. So with that, I'm going to stop the quiz demonstration. Thank you for watching. Keep subscribing to the channel. I request you to share with your friends and networks for this particular video for their benefit. Thank you all.